everybody, and welcome to Croftlands Community Church. I'm so pleased that you can join us this morning. My name's Karen, and I just want to say a really big welcome to you all, and it's so great to see you. How's your summer going? We're having a brilliant time, and I hope that you're enjoying spending some more time with friends and family. We've got some lovely weather at the minute, and I know two people who are really enjoying themselves.
Yay!
So coming up in this service, I'll be giving a short testimony, there'll be some worship songs, and there'll be some time of reflection. And I do hope and I pray that you will just enjoy dwelling in God's presence and reflecting and thinking about His goodness and His greatness.
Sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. Oh, Jesus.
So I've just been asked to share a little bit with you about what I felt a welcoming church would be, or maybe what it would look like. And I just felt like I wanted to share with you a testimony that Adam and I experienced 10 years ago. When we were struggling with my pregnancy, and what happened was we were told that Annabelle was going to be born with heart problems, so we needed to go and have her in Newcastle at Newcastle Hospital. And at the time, obviously, it was very upsetting. It was very difficult news to come to terms with, and we were told to prepare for at least a month. So we were having to prepare to go to Newcastle, to go to a strange place where we didn't know anyone, we didn't have any family, we didn't have any friends there. And you know, we were going to have to prepare for this time at Newcastle, and we knew that we were going to have to spend a lot of time in the hospital there, and that Annabelle wasn't going to be very well. So the first thing I did was I looked on the internet to find a church at Newcastle, because I just felt that we needed to be part of a family and part of a community. So I reached out to a church there, which was Tyneside Vineyard, and I sent an email explaining what was happening and what was happening to our situation. And I got a lovely email back, and it was so welcoming, and they said, next time you come up, why don't you come and meet with us, and we'll invite all of our church community over so that you can meet key people who are willing to help you. They gave us a piece of paper with everybody's name and contact numbers on, who were willing to like offer us food or do some washing for us, or at any time if we needed some help we were able to phone them. And we just got such a lovely, lovely welcome, and we were just blown away by the generosity of how they were with a complete stranger. You know, because they didn't know who we were. We weren't part of their church, but we turned up in need. And that was a humbling experience, because often we don't like to depend on other people. We like to be independent. And so we had to accept help from people. And, you know, the pastors, it turned out, lived 3 streets away from the hospital. It was absolutely incredible. And we were able to go around and have food with them. They would drop off any kind of spare food that they had left over, and they would drop it round. They sent us a key in the post for their house and said that they would be away when we arrived, but we could use their drive to park the car on, we could use the washing machine. And so we were just absolutely inundated with offers and support from a welcoming, welcoming church. And you know, I think that's how, when I think about Catherine and what she was saying over the last few months about how church needs to be welcoming, that we welcome strangers, that we love people, that we support people. And you know, I've experienced that firsthand, and I just was, even though it was such a difficult time for us, we ended up being there for 9 months. We had a lovely church family, we had friends, and we didn't feel alone. And it was just incredible that even though it was a very difficult time, it was one of the best times as well, because we trusted in God. We found out that it didn't matter where we were, the church families extended across the nation, across the world, and that we can belong and be part of God's big family.
Dollars stripped away.
search much deeper within. Through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you.
From 2 Corinthians chapter 12, starting at verse 9. But he said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses, in insults, in hardships, in persecutions, in difficulties. For when I am weak, then I am strong." And you know, I just love those verses because I just think when you are weak, when you have nothing, when all has been stripped away, you know, we went to Newcastle, our family was stripped away, our work was stripped away, our house had been stripped away. We were in such a strange land that we were immensely blessed. And I think it became actually quite fun to count our blessings, to think even though we're experiencing such a tough and difficult time, let's count our blessings and let's see how God is with us. And it was just so encouraging, and we just knew that God was there right with us all the way through, and he still is right now. And, you know, I love those verses that when we are weak, then he is strong in us. And, you know, I just think it's just such a powerful, powerful thing that we've experienced. You know, it's just been such a life-changing event that we've realised that when you do ultimately have to depend, when you can't control your situation, when you can't just make everything better, no money, nothing can change anything apart from just being where you are, just being planted, being rooted where you are, and just depending on God. And that is when you will see that he will bless you and that he's there and that he's going to take you through these hard times.
Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name in the land that is plentiful, where your streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when found in the desert place, the walk through the wilderness. Blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your glory. Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name
on the road marked with suffering.
Blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering, where there's pain in the offering. Blessed be your name. Blessing you pour out, I turn back to praise. And when the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your glory. Blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your name,
oh God.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your glorious name.
You give and take,
you give and take away, you give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. You give and take away. Lord, you give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name,
oh Father.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
Glorious name.
A love with a difference. I believe his grace and mercy, although I may not see. I can feel his peaceful presence and his love for me. His physical appearance to myself may not be known, but the spirit is revealed in my life, so I know I'm not alone. My path is never clear to me, but to him it is as crystal. For God has specifically chosen me, and it wasn't accidental. Magnificently moving and perfectly performing, all done in such glorious ways. Blessed is he who has life like me, with joy in all his days. And when I don't listen to good advice and disobey God's holy will, my forgiving Father gently whispers my name and says, I love you still.
God is graciously pure and is continually my father, my brother, and my friend. But unlike everything in this life, the difference is his love will never end.
Thank you so much, Karen, for sharing with us today. I've been really blessed by listening, and I'm sure many other people will be too. Before Karen closes the service, we have a birthday to celebrate. John has his birthday on Saturday, that's the 21st of August. Some of you may not know, but John is quite artistic and produces some great graffiti-style art. So here's some street art to celebrate you, John. God bless you, and have a great birthday on Saturday.
May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and evermore. Amen.